Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me tell you why when you start your Mac up, lots of apps and windows open up automatically. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a very common question asked online is, when you start up your Mac, why do all of these apps and these windows automatically open? Is there a way to have your Mac start up with nothing going on? Well, there's a lot going on inside this question. The first thing I want to address is that most Mac users don't ever really need to shut down their Macs at all. So if you don't shut down your Mac, you never need to start it up. A restart's kind of the same thing, but you also should only rarely need to restart your Mac, maybe after a major software update or installation. A lot of Mac users still shut down their Macs when they're done using it at the end of the day, and you really don't need to do that. Just put your Mac to sleep. If you have a MacBook model, then the only time you really need to do more than put your Mac to sleep is if you're storing it for a long period of time. If you have a desktop Mac, then you obviously need to shut down your Mac to move it somewhere since you're unplugging it, but other than that, just let it sleep. In fact, Macs do a lot of maintenance while they're sleeping, and if you don't let them sleep, they'll do that maintenance while you're using your Mac, causing your Mac to be slower. Even doing something as simple as indexing the files on your drive for Spotlight so you can search and find them could take days or weeks if you're always shutting down your Mac as soon as you're done using it and only starting it up again when you start using it. Instead, if you let it sleep, it'll take care of that while you're not using your Mac at all, making it faster for you while you do use it. Okay, so besides that, why when you restart your Mac do all of these apps and windows open up? A lot of the advice you'll find online is wrong. For instance, they'll tell you to go into System Preferences and then go to Users and Groups and from there go to Login Items and look to see which apps are set to automatically start. But chances are you're not going to find the problem here. Many of you may see nothing at all in this list. And you almost certainly won't see apps like Pages and Safari and Mail in this list. They won't be set here to start up automatically. There are other ways for apps to start up automatically, but it's unlikely that this is the problem that people are talking about. Another thing people will tell you to look for is if you go to System Preferences and then General, there's a setting here, Close Windows When Quitting an App. And this seems like it may address the problem, but this just has to do with quitting the app. So for instance, if you have two Pages documents open, if you were to suddenly quit Pages with Command Q, and then restart Pages, it would automatically open up those two windows with those two documents. This is a great feature, but it doesn't apply when you're restarting or shutting down. Even though restarting and shutting down does of course quit apps, even if you have this turned on, when you restart, you may find that Pages opens up again with those two windows. So what's actually causing all of your previous apps to restart automatically? After all, you may think that if you choose restart or shut down, it quits all apps, and then when you start up the Mac, you'll see no apps open. Well, you got to pay careful attention when you choose one of these. For instance, if I choose shut down, notice I've got this dialog box here and there's a checkbox and the checkbox says reopen Windows when logging back in. So this is actually what's doing it here. This overrides that system preference in general and will actually reopen all of the apps you had and all of the windows in them. To prevent this from happening, simply uncheck this. The same exact thing appears when you go to restart or to log out. You'll get this checkbox here. So if you've got 10 apps running and you want to restart your Mac and not have those 10 apps running, then you've got to uncheck this box. And the best thing about it is that it remembers your last setting. Matter of fact, I don't even have to restart here. I can actually cancel and I can see that when I choose this, it will in fact remember that last setting. So you can change it now. So the next time you need to restart or shut down, it actually will be set as you like. Now there's one exception to this, and that's the Finder. If you've got Finder windows open, like here's one, here's another, and you've got these set up, then Finder, even though of course it is quitting the Finder when you shut down, everything has to quit, and it should be obeying the rules in System Preferences and this checkbox here, in fact, Finder windows will reopen. So the Finder kind of remains constant between when you shut down or restart your Mac and when it starts up again. Of course, you can easily click the red button here to close any Finder window. Doing that before or after you restart is fine. You could also go to File and where it says close window, that changes to close all if you hold the option key down. So the keyboard shortcut option command W will close all Finder windows. That actually works in most apps. And another thing that adds to the confusion here is the fact that Mac apps have a fundamental difference in how they work from Windows apps. So if you come from Windows, you may think that if you are in an app like here I am in Pages and you click the red X here, that Pages quits. But you can see it doesn't. You've simply closed a document window for Pages and Pages stays open. This is really handy because it allows you to close a document or window and then open a new one without having to relaunch the app again. And the same is true in Safari. Here I've got a Safari window open, and if I click the X there, Safari remains open. And now I can go and use history, bookmarks, or whatever I want to open another Safari page. So if you want to actually quit Safari, what you need to do is choose Quit Safari in the Safari menu, or just Command Q. Now in Pages, if I use Quit Pages or Command Q, it's going to obey the setting here in System Preferences General as to whether windows are closed when quitting the app. So since I have this turned off, it won't actually close the window. So I quit Pages and then I start Pages up again, and it will automatically bring that window with that document back. You can, however, override this on a case-by-case basis. If I go to Pages, Quit Pages, and hold the Option key down, you can see it says Quit and Close All Windows. So Command Option Q will do that. Now when I start Pages again, you can see it's just prompting me to open a new document here. That Pages document was closed. Oh, and by the way, if you have this checked, then in Pages you'll see that the Quit command with the Option key is actually Quit and Keep All Windows now. So it does the opposite of the System Preferences setting. So I hope this gives you a better understanding of why windows and documents may automatically open when you restart or shut down and start up your Mac, and why document windows may reappear when you launch an app. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.